Then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes out of his tent, looks in the heavens, and he says, Allahu Akbar, Jibreel with 3,000 angels descending down to support the believers. During the month of Ramadan, on the 17th of Ramadan, it was the great battle, the battle of Badr. That great battle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also describes as the battle of the Furqan, the distinguisher, the distinguished between the haq, the truth, and the batil, the falsehood. And the great battle of Badr is known to the scholars as the first major battle that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had participated in. And it all begins when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam receives the news that Abu Sufyan is leading a great caravan of hundreds of camels. Abu Sufyan is arriving back with great profit from Syria to the people of Quraysh. And when the news arrives, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam decides to intercept this caravan and take what this caravan had carried to avenge for his people and compensate his people, in particular what the people of Quraysh had done to the believers in Mecca. They've taken their own wealth, taken their own homes, taken their own lands, and they even killed some of them. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has the rights to retaliate and avenge for his people and compensate himself by attacking the caravan of those who had attacked him before. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam marches out of Medina with a small number of companions. 313 believers, 313 companions marched with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Medina. All came out with the intention to attack a caravan that the people of that caravan do not exceed 50 of them. None of them came out with the intention of war. None of them came out with the intention of fighting. So they all came out with literal weapons. The maximum one of them had was one sword and one shield. But Abu Sufyan was smart. And Abu Sufyan heard the intentions of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and his marching of Medina. So Abu Sufyan managed to escape from where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had planned to meet him. And at the same time, Abu Sufyan, and that's before Abu Sufyan was a Muslim, sent one of his men to the people of Quraysh, calling upon the people of Quraysh, saying to them that Muhammad had came out with 313 soldiers to attack your wealth and your caravan. So prepare an army and come out to attack Muhammad. So Abu Jahl, la'anahullah, with all this hostility and enmity towards Islam and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he prepared an army of 1,300 soldiers. And then Abu Sufyan managed to escape. So he sent the news to Abu Jahl, informing him that there's no need for you to come out of Mecca and march out of Mecca with that number of soldiers. Your caravans, your wealth, your stock, your money, your valuables are now secured. So go back to Mecca. But Abu Jahl insisted that he wants to fight Muhammad. Abu Jahl insisted that he'll meet with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam's army at Badr and fight them and crush the army of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, not knowing that هذا بروفا عليه الصلاة والسلام has the Lord of the universe supporting him صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the news comes to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام that Abu Sufyan managed to escape. And now النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام is between the choice of going back to Medina without anything, as he promised his people that will attack the caravan of the people of Quraysh and compensate them of their loss that they lost in Mecca, or stand in front of an army that the number of this army exceeds the number of his army 3 to 4 times. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was put in an embarrassing situation in front of his sahaba. So he gathered them and he stood in front of them and addressed them and he said, I promised you that we'll come out and attack the caravan of Abu Sufyan and compensate ourselves from the loss that we had lost in Mecca and come out and come back with spoils and booty to Medina. But unfortunately, as you all heard, Abu Sufyan managed to escape and go the other route and other way to go to Mecca. And now the people of Quraysh had came out with 1,300 of their men to face you and fight you. So what's your opinion? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not prepared. The army of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam is not prepared. Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam had 313 soldiers, while the disbelievers had 1,300. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had 2 horses in his entire camp, while the disbelievers had over 200 horses. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had 70 camels for 313, while the disbelievers of Quraysh had over 1,000 camels. Where's the balance here? Where is the balance here? So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is standing in front of his sahaba addressing them, saying to them, I promised you one thing, but now it's war. And it's war with people, their number is 3 to 4 times our number, and they're a lot more prepared than us. So what do you say? Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the first companion to stand up and show his support to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by saying to the Messenger of Allah, O Messenger of Allah, go, we are behind you. Then it was Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu to get up and show his support to the Messenger of Allah and say to the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, O Muhammad, go, we are behind you. And then it was al-Miqdad ibn al-Aswad radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He gets up and he says, O Messenger of Allah, O Messenger of Allah, do you think we will say to you what the people of Israel and the children of Israel said to Musa when Musa commanded them to enter Jerusalem or the sacred land? Go you and your Lord fight, we are sitting over here. We're not going to say to you what the people of Israel said. Go you and your Lord fight, we are sitting here. We're going to say to you, go you and your Lord fight, we are coming with you. But this, 3 leaders and 3 men, Abu Bakr, Umar, Al-Miqdad, were from the Muhajirin, from the migrants. And the majority of people with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and out of those 313 soldiers with him, the majority of them are from the Ansar, are from the Medina. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam wanted to hear their stance. He wanted to hear what they think. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, with his wisdom, he looks towards them and then he says to them, tell me what you think, all people. Tell me. Suggest to me, all people. So Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, the leader and the chief of the people of Ansar, the one that when he died, the Messenger of Allah said, this is a man that the throne of Allah shook because of his death. He gets up and he says, O Messenger of Allah, are you referring to us, the Ansar? النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, yes, indeed. What's your opinion? What's your stance? Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, he says, O messenger of Allah, Allah sent you to us with the truth. And we followed you. You commanded us, we obeyed. You forbidded us, we abstained. O messenger of Allah, O messenger of Allah, we had given you our oath and our pledges that will stand by you no matter what the situation is. And by Allah, if you go through the oceans, we will be behind you. Today is the day that Allah Azza wa Jal wants to show you that we are real men and we stick by our words. By Allah, we are very patient when it comes to fighting and very firm when it comes to the walls. رضي الله تعالى عنه. So النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم seized his great enthusiasm and momentum from the companions. So he relies on his Lord and marches towards Badr to meet with the people of Quraysh. Until the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم arrives to Badr 150 kilometers from Medina. Halfway through to Mecca, where the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam will camp there with the believers, waiting for the arrival of the disbelievers. 1,300 of them, when the news arrived to them that Abu Sufyan had secured the caravan, 300 of them retreated and went back to Mecca. Abu Jahl is left with 1,000. Still, 1,000 from 313, that's triple the number of the believers. Until that moment came where the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is addressing his companions, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam is reminding the believers what Allah azza wa jal had promised them, either victory in the battle of Badr or paradise to those who die in this battlefield. There is no loss. The believers will never lose if they are with Allah. How could an army lose when it's assisted by Allah? How could an army lose when it's supported by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Either one of two. Victory or martyrdom. Victory from Allah or paradise to those who die on the battlefield. And now Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lines up this minority army. 313, not even prepared to fight, with very minimal weapons and shields, two horses. And then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam starts to divide his camps and divides the soldiers into platoons. The platoon of the Ansar, led by Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, and the platoon of the Muhajirin, led by Ali ibn Abi Talib. On the right wing, Al-Zubayr ibn Awam with his horse. On the left wing, Al-Miqdad ibn Aswad with his horse. And the general banner was in the hands of Mus'ab ibn Umair, and the leadership was in the hands of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam will be built for him a tent to be his headquarters. And there the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that night, the night of the 17th of Ramadan, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, while all the companions are sleeping, and Allah azza wa jalla says, and we sent upon them to sleep comfortably that night. It was a blessing from Allah azza wa jalla upon them. But the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was awake. Awake with her, awake with his Lord Allah Almighty, asking Allah Azza wa Jal to give this minority soldiers victory over their enemies that entire night. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam is supplicating and praying to Allah, asking Allah to give him victory over his enemies. Until that moment, where the people of Quraysh had arrived He stood in front of the camp of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. And from far away the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام can see them standing. And Allah عز وجل makes their numbers little in the eyes of the Sahaba so they do not lose motivation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the numbers of the Sahaba small in the eyes of the disbelievers so they could have more motivation to fight them. Allah wants it to happen. Allah Azza wa Jal wants this battle to happen. So I could prove to everyone that when the haq comes, there is no room for the batil. When the haq comes, the haq prevails the batil. When Muhammad is there and the soldiers who follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the victory is always with them. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encourages his companions to be firm and to remind them that whoever fights for the sake of Allah firm and strong on this day, Allah will give him the paradise. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam lines up his camps, his soldiers. And then the people of Quraysh will come forward and ask the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam to send out three of his main strong men to fight against three of their main men. Who are the three main men from the people of Quraysh? Utba, Shaybah, and his son Al-Walid. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam sends out three people from the Ansar, from the Medina. So Utba, Shaybah, and Walid look at them and say, who are you? They say, we are from Medina. So they say to them, you are generous, noble people. We don't want to fight you. We want people from our own blood, from our own kind. We want people from the people of Mecca who migrated to you. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he calls upon and he says, O Hamza, O Ali, O Ubaidah, get up for the paradise. The width of that paradise as wide as the heavens and the earth. Get up. Get up and fight these people. So they get up. Hamza, Ali, and Ubaidah. Three of them from the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Three of them from the direct family of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. To fight against three strong, powerful warriors from the people of Quraysh. Hamza kills his opponent. Ali kills his opponent. Ubaidah, he injures his opponent, and his opponent injures him until Hamza and Ali attacked the opponent of Ubaidah, and three of them killed the disbelievers. Brought the morale of the believers high. Took the morale of the disbelievers down. And now, 330 to fight against 1,000. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is watching. He raises his hands. Oh Allah! Oh Allah! The victory that you had promised me. Oh Allah! The victory they had promised me. And Abu Bakr, his deputy, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, behind him, hearing the dua of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So he calms him down and he says to him, O Messenger of Allah, you've insisted on your Lord so much. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is calling upon his Lord and Master, O Allah, the victory that you had promised me. Then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes out of his tent, looks in the heavens, and he says, Allahu Akbar, Jibreel with 3,000 angels descending down to support the believers. The victory of Allah is always with those who give victory back to Allah.
And there is a narration, very clear cut, authentic narration that makes mention of the fact that Shaytan came to them. And Shaytan told them on that day of Badr that you will not lose. I am with you and I am the one who's going to help you and so on. So in what form did Shaytan come? In the form of a man known as Suraqah bin Malik. I'm sure you've heard the name before. If you recall when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was making the hijrah. This Suraqah bin Malik, Shaytan used to come in his form. More than once he has come in the form of this man. May Allah protect us. So Shaytan came and Shaytan promised them that, look, I am with you. You will definitely win. There is no chance that those people can win. And then when the two armies had finally clashed, Shaitan saw the angels, Jibreel and Mikael. The angels were from amongst those who had come down in their thousands by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's will and instruction, and Shaitan ran away. They actually saw the Suraqah bin Malik go away. Abu Jahl tells him, where are you going? He says, no, I am going. And he began to run. They tried to get hold of him. They couldn't. He ran away. Abdurrahman ibn Auf radiallahu anhu makes mention in a hadith, which is also authentic, mashallah. Abdurrahman ibn Auf radiallahu anhu says, there were two young boys from the Ansar. Young boys. One was Mu'adh ibn Afra radiallahu anhu, and the other one was Mu'adh ibn Amr ibn al-Jamuh radiallahu anhu. The two of them, young boys, came to me, he says. And they told me, uncle, literally that word, uncle, who is Abu Jahl? So Abdurrahman ibn Auf says, I looked at him and I said, what do you want with Abu Jahl? He's the leader of this army here. What do you want with him? No, we've heard that he swears Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We've heard that he has caused much suffering to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today we want to sort him out. Subhanallah, young boys. Now had these people been older, they would not have been able to cross the lines and the ranks of the mushriks, because their leader was heavily protected. But because they were young, they got away with it. What happened is Abdurrahman ibn Auf says, after some time I saw Abu Jahl and I showed them. There he is and he shows them. They were so happy. He says, no sooner did I say this than they had already got to him. And what they had done, they got him off his little horse and they had started striking him. And the people around didn't even notice that these two were attacking. Besides the son of Abu Jahl, Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl, he struck one of them quite badly. In fact, he struck Mu'adh ibn Amr ibn al-Jamuh to the degree that one narration says he lost part of his hand. But by this time, the youngster had already struck Abu Jahl, who was on the ground, and he was already almost complete, almost finished. He was just making a bit of noise this way, that way, breathing heavily, and he had already had bodily injuries that were quite severe. And in no time, the other youngster comes. And when he came in, Mu'adh ibn Afra, he had struck Abu Jahl and ensured that now there is no movement of this particular man. He was still breathing, but there was no movement. This was the leader of the Meccan army, taken on by two little boys from the Ansar. Subhanallah.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfills His promise. Where Allah azza wa jal will give victory to those minority, 313, against the majority, 1,000 of disbelievers. 70 from amongst the disbelievers were killed, and 70 were captives, and only 14 from amongst the Muslims were killed. The victory of Allah. And amongst those who were killed in that battle, the heads and the chiefs of the people of Quraysh, Abu Jahl, Umayyah, Utbah, Shayba, Al-Walid, those who used to make mockery of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, those who used to fight the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Before the battle, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam told them, by Allah, I could see Abu Jahl dead over here, and I could see Umayyah dead over here, and I could see Shayba dead over there. And exactly where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam pointed, they will die. They were all dead over there. Allah is great. Allah is great, and Islam is great. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had always promised victory to Islam. The battle that Allah azza wa jal fulfilled His promise to the companions. It is a great battle for us to remember. In a day like this day, exactly 1,432 years ago, victory to the believers was never, ever, ever granted to them because of their large numbers. Not because of their artillery or weaponry. Not because of their influence or knowledge. Victory was always granted to them when they were with Allah Azza wa Jal. When they were firm believers. When they were strong believers. Who feared no one but Allah, like this Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu. They stood firm in front of their enemies. Even though their enemies are three times more than them, but they had no fear except from Allah. and they relied on no one except Allah. And because of that, Allah gave them victory.
Da 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 da